Hi everyone and welcome to this new Twinmotion tutorial. In today's video, we are going to have a look at how to navigate in or around your project. When you first launch Twinmotion, you have that ribbon at the top of the screen, where you can find the most important shortcut to navigate in your scene. First, you have the shortcut on your mouse. On the left click, you have the orbit. So here, when I click inside my viewport, it will start to orbit based on where I clicked. So here, for example, if I click on my house, which is in the middle of my scene, I will start to orbit around my house. But here, if I move my mouse on the right of the screen where this tree is, and if I click there, I will start to orbit around that tree. So the orbit is really based on where the pointer of your mouse is when you click. The second icon in that ribbon is for the pan. It's on the middle mouse button of your mouse. So here, if I click on that scroll wheel, I can see that I can pan. I can move the camera left, right, up and down. With the right click, finally, I can turn the camera around. So for example here, if I want to go a bit inside my project, I will be able to just look around inside my house. Let's talk now about the navigation key on your keyboard. Here you have W, A, S and D if you are using a QWERTY keyboard. But I'm personally using an AZERTY keyboard. You can find the shortcut in the bottom right corner of each key on that diagram. If you press Z or W, here you will move forward. If you press S, you will move backward. Q or E, you will move to the left. And D, you will move to the right. Finally, A or Q and E will move the camera up and down. There are also a lot of different speeds you can use to navigate inside your project. You can find those speeds by clicking on the I menu. The second icon here will allow you to switch from the fly speed to the inspect speed. Each of those speeds also are mapped on your keyboard with the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 keys just above the letters on your keyboard. Here you can also see that the speed here are mentioned also on that navigation bar. So for example, here if I start to navigate inside my scene, right now I am in the 1 speed. I can switch to the 2, which will be a bit faster, 3, which will be even more fast, 4, 5 and 6, which will be really fast. So it really depends on the kind of project you are working on. If you are working on a really large project, you will often use the speed number 6 to move from one side to the other pretty easily. But if we are working on a project in a similar scale to that lake house demo scene, the speed number 3 or 4 will be way more useful. At any moment, you can also enable the physics. This is what we call the pedestrian mode. You can find the shortcut here, the pedestrian mode. The shortcut to that is M. So here right now, I am in pedestrian mode. That means I am actually walking on the ground at the height of a human being. There are even some sounds created by the footstep of my camera walking around the project. If I want to move away from that walking mode, I will press again M. That will enable the drone view. And this way, now I can move around again. In addition to the speed you are currently on, you can also press at any moment Shift that will allow you to sprint, which will increase the speed of the selected speed you are in at the moment. So for example, here I will just place my camera like that. Let me close the door. I will start to move by pressing Z on my keyboard or W on a QWERTY keyboard. And here I will press Shift to momentarily sprint. It will be a tiny bit faster. So it's something if you don't want to just change the speed, if you want to quickly just jump a bit faster towards the location you are wanting to go to, you can just use that shift key. If you want to learn more about the shortcut, you can find that through the help button, shortcut, and here you can open a PDF on the language you are most comfortable with. In that PDF, you will find a shortcut for both Windows and Mac, and there is way more shortcut than the one that I mentioned today. For example, here, let me scroll down and have a look. On the left here, we can see some of the shortcuts I didn't mention to switch tools, like the Translate, Rotate and Scale, 7, 8 and 9. You can also, for example, press H to hide the selected object. Let's come back to Twinmotion and test this one in action. So for example, here, let me come to my living room. Let's say I don't want that small table here anymore. I can click on it and I can press H to hide it. I can press again H to unhide it. While we are talking about shortcuts, let's have a look at some of those. G is a shortcut I'm often using. It's to hide all the visual helper that you can have inside your scene. So for example, here, the visual helper present in my scene are those two lights here and here. Same thing, if I take a light from the library and drag and drop it inside my scene, you can see that small icon, which allows you to easily select your light in your viewport. You can press G on your keyboard to hide and unhide those visual helpers. When they are hidden, you can also select the light through the scene graph. The visual helper also hide the path. So here, for example, if I come to the path, character path, if I create a small path just in front of my project, like this, if I press G, I will see the path of the characters. We can see also a bit more things. For example, here we have a reflection probe, and here we have two lights, and finally here we have a rotator. Another useful shortcut is R to switch on the path tracer. When you click on the icon or when you mouse over the icon, this shortcut is actually visible in the tooltip R. So here is just a quick shortcut that I'm often using when working inside Twinmotion. As mentioned in that ribbon here, you can also use the arrow to navigate inside your scene. So here you can see the different icons that will allow you to move inside your project. And you can also use page up and page down to move the camera up and down. If you click on that wheel here, you will be able to change the shortcut based on your CAD software preference. So for example here, if you are coming from CET, you can switch to those shortcuts and you can see that here on the left button, it will be the pan, the look around will be on the middle mouse button while the orbit is on the right button. Once you are familiar with that ribbon and the shortcut, you can click on that icon to hide that panel. If you want to bring that panel up, you can click on the I menu, click on that icon and click on Show Navigation. For this video, I've been using a simple 3-button mouse, but Twinmotion works also perfectly with the 3D connection space mouse. Here, for example, I'm using the Space Mouse Enterprise to navigate fluently inside my scene, allowing me to move inside my project and also look around with just a single hand. Finally, if you have a gamepad, here is the shortcut to be able to navigate around. And that's it for this video. Thank you everyone for watching it and we will see you all for the next one. Bye everyone!